come here.
Is that smell?
Thank you.
It's over. Here they come. Get a load of this place. Thank you.
right.
Let's do this.
More bad news.
I've never seen anything like this before. quiet. Something's wrong. What's that smell?
Thank you.
That was rough. I don't like the looks of this. least that's over.
This way.
All right, that was the run. Sorry, I didn't. I'm not really good at doing like live commentary. Also, that run, I was like on the phone for half of it. Plus, I was also in the middle of like ordering food for dinner as well. So, it was pretty interesting run with all that going on. I just wanted to do a short explanation after explaining some of the rings I was swapping in and out. So, I was swapping rings towards the end of the run because I wanted more like safety hat stuff, just to keep myself alive, survivability. And the three rings I had on obviously were the Black Cat Man, the Encrypted Ring for that insane HP regen, and Heart of the Wolf just to get through the zones quicker, plus the extra stamina is nice for bosses and dodging and stuff. But if you really want to be that risky, you could just do the full damage build, which would be Burden the Destroyer, obviously. Get this up. the explosion ring and Burden of the Gambler. So the thing about Burden of the Gambler is I choose this over anything else because the fact that you're 100% critting at all your explosion damage, I believe crit damage will scale the most for damage to help you out. So with that plus probability cord, yeah, I'm at plus 95% crit damage. So that's some gnarly numbers here. I had Corrupted Meridian with Harmonizer on to instantly restore my charges from Prismatic Driver. Also Corrupted Meridian with that legendary trait. A lot of damage. So, I have Krellax with Volatile Strike on it. Obviously Volatile Strike because it'll 100% crit. I didn't really use my axe this run, no need to. In large part because I like the speed on it and I don't really use hearts as much because I'm kind of comfortable with most bosses and their mechanics. Obviously the Archon Summoner for the massive increase in damage to mod damage, explosion damage, and the mod power regen for it being on the primary. Fragments. You could swap out the third. You always want explosive damage, crit damage, 100%. And you can float the last fragment, you can help. You put movement speed if you want to go faster. You could go for mod damage. This prism is not perfect. Weak spot damage is not supposed to be there. I wanted something else to go there, but I got weak spot instead. I'm too lazy to start a prism over for plus 10 damage. I wanted crit damage, I believe. I forgot what I wrote down. But, yeah. That's the run. I just wanted to do a quick little explanation, because obviously I didn't commentate over it or anything live. So, that's it. I did have the movement speed on. I had Chilled Steam on just to keep moving faster. With this particular setup, like, the mod power regeneration is pretty comfortable. I didn't really need any increase to anything. As long as Corrupted Meridian was landing and Harmonizer was proccing, I always had 30 charges of Prismatic Driver. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. The consumables, obviously, gold chance and stamina, just in case I needed to be careful with some dodges or running, etc. Bright stones, obviously, to pad more damage. I only really threw them during, like, downtime, I guess. I didn't really use much of them, but I think it's more of like a DPS loss if I take time to throw it, but I also could be wrong. Fairy needles for the extra mod power regen, and the HP regen food that lasts 30 seconds too, just to have if I feel like I didn't need the enlarged tart. But that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll make more content soon.